knowing that desire is something of the mind, we cannot measure how much desire you have for anything. Maybe you have very little desire, or maybe a medium amount or quantity, or maybe a lot of desire. There's no way to measure, there's no instruments to measure the strength of desire in a person. So it has to be a mental something, a subjective something that's invisible, like accumulating energy that we cannot detect or measure in another dimension. Now, notice how conflicting it could be when you talk about habits. We have to have a strong desire to stop the habit and a weak desire towards the habit. So we need to know how to function, how to strengthen desire, and how to weaken desire. So to strengthen desire, you must think about what you desire more frequently. You see, there are several different faculties that are spiritual, strictly belong to the mental world, the invisible world of the mind. Desire is one of them, the basic one, desire, belief, expectancy, sometimes it's called hope, and love, meaning every time you want to strengthen your desire, think about what you desire. What is it you desire? Think about it frequently. The more the frequent thought about it, the stronger it gets. So you want to go over what you desire, either verbal or mental. Think about it and do it very frequently. This will build up the energy accumulated by desire for whatever that is. Okay, so now let's say that you have accumulated enough energy or a lot of energy with desiring by repeating frequently that you desire. Now, belief is another factor that has to go along with desire. Believing that you can accomplish what you desire, believing that you're going to apply this energy that you have accumulated with desire correctly in order to accomplish whatever you're looking for, what you desire. If you decide to stop whatever or decide to start anything, okay, it's the beginning of a movement towards your reaching your goal. But you see, you must have a strong belief factor to back it up. Now, how do you strengthen your belief factor? By believing more frequently that you desire, believing that you're going to accomplish it. So again, repeat what you believe in, the accomplishment of when using your desire to have accomplished that whatever that is, and repeat it frequently, and your belief factor will also accumulate a spiritual energy, intangible, spiritual, subjective energy in the world of the mind to be able to accomplish your goals in that you desire. Now, the other one would be hope or expectancy. Expect to find what you believe in that you desire, or to accomplish that you believe in and desire. That's your expectancy factor, or your hope to achieving your goal. Well, repeat the end results as though you already have it. You already have what? What you believe in and that you desire. And the more you repeat having arrived at your goal, having accomplished your objective, repeat that as frequently as possible. And again, you accumulate energy with the factor desire or hope. Now you have the three major faculties working in a certain direction to achieve your goals. Your desire enough energy to back it up, your belief in it enough energy to back it up, and having accomplished it as an end result already to back it up. Now the more you repeat this, the stronger it gets. And this is what's called faith by some people. We were told time and again, in many applications or experiences or instances, have hope, my son, sometimes they used to tell me, but they didn't tell me what that means. How can I develop hope? I mean, what is this? Or have faith, my son. Well, what is faith? I mean, I don't know what that is in order to accomplish it. I'm being told to have faith, and if I don't know what that is, how can I get it or look for it and find it? Well, now we know that the strengthening of your desire, the strengthening of your belief mechanism, the strengthening of your hope or expectancy mechanism is what we mean, or it was meant by faith. Now, remember that, how can you tell that this is true? You can apply it to love, for instance. Love, the more you think about the person you love, the more you're going to love the person. The more frequent that you think about the person you love, the stronger the love for that person. The less you think about the person, the less you repeat it, the less love you will have for that person or that something. It's the same dimension. It's a faculty of the mind, like desire, belief, and hope or expectancy. Love is another one. So keep that in mind, and whatever you desire, repeat it frequently. Whatever you believe in, repeat it frequently. And whatever you hope for, repeat it frequently. And whoever you love, repeat that one also frequently, and you will have a stronger love for that person.